Just present in the meeting and left. Oh, awesome. I'm getting responses now. Okay. So, yeah, how was your Sunday? Like every other day, or maybe enjoyed a little? Okay. No other responses. Come on, girls, on Sunday you can't be so low. Just say at least it was like every other day from the past 1.5 year, maybe. Okay, anyhow, I don't think you are interested in any chit chat. Let's get into the session. Okay. Thank God, at least one person is responding. Let me share my screen. I hope my voice is audible and is having no disturbances, right? Awesome. Okay. And also my screen is visible now. Yeah. Okay. Please let me know in case of any disturbances, okay? The weather here don't seem to be very great. So, yeah, please let me know. So yesterday, till where did we discuss? What all did we learn? What all we understood till now, from the day one of our session till now? Do you feel you are good in the topics which we have discussed till now? How much will you rate on these topics? You yourself have to rate yourself. You tell me, how much will you rate yourself? How, in the scale of 5? Yeah. No ratings? Come on, you should say something. Great. 3 and 4, I see. Okay. Mm-hmm. 3.5. Okay. So there are floats also. I thought only integers. Okay. 3.5. 4. Anybody who's, I am seeing if I get any 5. I really wanted to see a 5. 1, 5. Come on, you should be confident on yourself, right? Awesome. So you are 3, or you're rating yourself as 3 or 4 just because maybe you did not, completely do something new out of what you have learned, right? After the session, maybe you did not go and try something out. If you try, definitely you would say, yeah, ma'am, I'm good. And I'm like, what did you even teach? This is all the same thing which we learned in C, C++, Java. It's just a syntax difference. There are little minute changes which we could grab it off, right? So practice will make you perfect in this. Don't worry. Don't think, yeah, I'm not understanding. How will I proceed further and learn the other things? No, we have 1 week from one session to the, from today to the next session, right? So most probably I'll be trying to finish off function. I'll try to finish off functions and also try to cover exception handling here in today's session. So what you people do is, from today, I mean like from tomorrow, till next Saturday we meet, till the time we meet, you people please keep practicing these topics which we have already discussed, because these will make a lot of difference in the in machine learning, okay, while you are doing machine learning. Okay, so while we are writing the algorithm, the code for the algorithm, we will be using these basics only. Okay, so at that time, if you don't have practice, I will have to explain you these basics again, okay, which is a little more time consuming. And if I think of 5 algorithms and if you are not able to understand the basics and I'm reiterating everything, it will take, or it will, I mean, like I can cover only 2 algorithms. So you will lose, right? So that's the reason I'm saying, please practice as much as you can. Do whatever you want, okay? Make mistakes. Please make mistakes. If you make 100 mistakes, you will remember. Only then you will remember. If you think, okay, this is very easy, I already understood now, so I will not write it again or I will not execute it again. Definitely, I'm telling you, even if it is the easiest of the easy thing, you will forget. Please remember this. And for maybe my pressure, please go and then execute at least once. Okay? Every single line, execute it at least once. Write some code, okay, which is not relevant to you, and then try to do it, okay? Only then you will, you know, you will see a different person in yourself. You will understand programming better. That's how you learn programming. Okay, so without wasting further time, let's get into today's topic. I don't know if you have, I mean, like maybe you felt bored with this gnan which I gave, but that is important, okay? Let's get into the topic. Today's topic is, as I already told you, we have learned about the basics. What did we learn? We first started with variables. We understood, I told you, right? In Python, we don't call them as variables. They are known as references. Because in Python, we see each object as a, like each and every element as an object, not as a, you know, memory location or something like that. We see them as a reference, right? So, these references are what, how many of you here already know what is object-oriented programming? Okay, I should put the question the other way around. How many of you have no idea about what are references? What are objects? What are OOPs? Please put it in the chat. At least you can answer this. This is related to our topic, right? So please put it in the chat. Who is completely unaware about what are OOPs? What are objects? What are classes? Completely unaware. I have no knowledge on object-oriented programming. So please, those people, please put... Okay, Aisha says she has slight idea, okay. Ramya doesn't know, okay. Bhavna, no idea, okay. Girls, quickly, like, you know, based on your response, I will see how I should tell you the way I'll have to mold, right? Okay. So, okay, I got one. Okay, almost a good number. Fine. So, okay, fine, no problem. So, let me just, you know, make it little simple. Let's not go into the depths of OOPs at this point, okay? So, let me just, you know, be on the upper layer and then talk. So, see, I told you we have references in Python, okay? Reference means what? You are an entity, real life entity. Okay, you are a person, I am a person, right? Everybody in this session is a person, right? A person becomes a real life entity. To identify each person has a separate name. I am named Lalita Gayatri. If you call, hey person, who will respond to you? Definitely no one, right? Because they don't know whom you are calling, right? When you say, hey Lalita, then I will... People with name Lalita will respond, okay? So each real life entity, even if they're, see, each real life entity will have few features, okay? What are features? Like, a person is a real life entity. To this person, it has hands, legs, everything, right? So, having these attributes like hands, these are all attributes, hands, legs, eyes, nose, mouth, ear, these become the attributes of a real life entity. Like for a car, it has wheels, it has steering, it has doors, windows, right? And it can perform few functions. A real life entity called person can walk, can run, can sit, can read, can see. These are the operations or the actions which it can perform, right? Coming to programming also, in programming, we have a concept called object-oriented programming. In object-oriented programming, we refer to real-life entities like person, like car, okay? So, one real-life entity will have some features, some attributes, and some functionalities which the real-life entity can perform, okay? And now with these attributes and these functionalities, entity is defined. Okay, let's say a person entity is defined. Now what I do to uniquely identify each person, I give it a separate name, right? It is known as a reference. Got it? Did you all understand this? Anybody has any doubts? You might wonder why I am talking about all this when I want to talk about functions. I will explain you why I was telling you all this, but remember this. All of you understood in the session. Anybody has any questions? Remember, we have real life entities. To access each real life entity, we create a reference or an object to it. Okay? To uniquely identify that particular, real life entity. Okay, Lalita becomes one reference to a person entity. Okay, so there is an entity called person. For that, Lalita is one object. Nidhi is one object. Harshini is one object. Soumya is one object. Like that. Got it, everybody? In the similar way, while we are creating variables, okay, in Python, if we are creating a variable, A, it is referencing, it is a reference value to A. Suppose if you are trying to store 10 in A, okay? So 10 is which type of value, all of you? 10 is which type of value? Integer, right? So there is an integer entity to that you are referencing using A. Did you get my point? There is an integer entity. You are referencing that integer entity using the variable A. Okay? Like person entity and Lalita are object, A is an object, a reference. Got it, everybody? Everybody is clear. Now, if I'm storing A equal to, in double quotes, Lalita, what does this mean? A is a reference to what? A is a reference to what when I say A equal to Lalita? To a string, right? To a string entity, it is a reference. You all got this, right? So we are dealing with objects in Python. Everything which we create, A equal to 10 is an object created to an integer class. Okay? Here entities are known as classes. References are known as objects. Remember this terminology, also write it down somewhere if necessary. Here on, I will be using these terms synonymously. I can call them as entities or classes. Okay? I can call A, B, C, D, whatever variables we are creating as references or objects. Okay? Got it? So put it in brain or write it down somewhere. Okay? Classes or entities are same. Which means a real-time, real-life body in the sense, it can be anything. To that, a specific name is given, it becomes an object. Done? Now, so we started with understanding how these references are created or variables are created. Okay? How dynamically values are assigned. How the GC removes the variable, right? Then we understood what are data types, what are all possible types of values which a reference can store. Okay. Then we further went, we understood what are all operations which you can perform. Operators are there in Python. Then we saw what are strings, right? Then we saw about the control statements. We understood about the collection data types, about the list, tuple, set, and dictionary. Can somebody in you illustrate, I mean, like, just explain me the difference, explain me and all the others in the session about what are all the differences about these four collection types. List, tuple, set, and dictionary. What is the major difference between these four collection types and how do you differentiate each of them? You can unmute your mic and talk rather than typing. Whoever tells this answer will receive a chocolate. Come on, girls.
Ma'am, list is list has indexing.
Yes. So Gayatri is speaking.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, tell me.
Indexing is present and sliced.
It is?
Can be sliced.
It can be sliced, yes. Okay.
And
it is mutable. Okay.
Tuple, it is also heterogeneous.
Okay.
Indexing can be done.
Okay.
Slicing, and it is immutable, ma'am.
Okay. What do you mean by immutable?
The value cannot be changed.
Awesome. Okay. How do I differentiate between list and tuple?
List has a square bracket.
Okay.
Tuple and tuple. Is the random.
Oh, okay. Great. Okay. Next.
And set heterogeneous. Mm. It has no indexing.
Mm-hmm.
And unique values.
Okay.
And no slicing also because no indexing.
Okay, great.
And it is mutable, obviously.
Yeah. Mm.
And dictionary.
Mm.
Key value pair. It has keys and values.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Indexing will be done using keys.
Okay.
And I guess it is immutable.
Uh-huh, okay.
Key immutable, ma'am.
Okay. So dictionary is mutable or immutable? Keys are immutable, fine. What about dictionary? Is dictionary mutable or immutable? Mutable. I would say everybody, you can give a big round of applause for Gayatri because she, before everybody, I mean, like, as when everybody was silent, when nobody opened their mouth, Gayatri opened her mouth and she did everything correctly. But one small, I would correct you in a place, Gayatri. The thing being, dictionary is mutable. Okay, you are accessing, you are able to access the elements using the key, right? When you are able to access the element using the key, I showed you that day. If name was Isha first, and then I changed it to Lalita, right? So using the key, just like list, how do you do list of 0 equal to some value you write, right? In the similar manner, in dictionary, what do you write? List of whatever key. For whichever key you want to change the value, that equal to the value which is there. I hope you understood. It's not very difficult, right? Did you understand, Gayatri?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, dictionary is mutable. That's the only thing. You are right. Keys are immutable. You should always make keys immutable and keys should be unique. You can't have duplicate keys. Okay? Values can be anything, that's up to you. Okay. And then I will also appreciate Vindhu for writing down it in the chat. Thanks, Bindu. So, yes. So, this is what we covered all these days. I hope everybody is clear with all these topics. Nobody has no questions, right? Chocolate will be given to Gayatri, Aisha. You don't speak for answering, but you're asking me chocolate? Chocolate will be given to Gayatri by end of the session.
How now?
I will give no. Gayatri can do anything. Your name is also Gayatri. You can't ask for questions. Huh? We are all universal. We can do anything and everything. By end of session, Gayatri will get a chocolate. Anyhow, so yeah, going further. So nobody has no more questions, right? On any of the topics which I just discussed. No doubts. Girls, 79 people are there. I receive responses only for five or six. What does that mean? All the others are understanding or they are not listening to the session itself. Okay. Awesome. Fine. So let's move. And today let's understand about functions. Why do we need them and how we can define functions in Python? Okay. Now, again, I need to adjust my screen a little. Okay, fine. I think this is enough. Fine. Are you all able to see my screen? I mean, like, is it visible? I mean, okay. So the size and all is fine, right? Cool. Great. So let's understand functions. Why do we have to go to functions? Anybody? Can anybody tell me why do we actually write functions? What are functions and why do we write functions?
For code reusability.
Uh-huh. Okay, why are you so serious, dear? Okay, for code reusability. Then? What else? That's it? What is a function? It is self-defined block of statement to perform a... Hey, is this a Google definition or is it what you wrote? Perform a coherent task. Come on, this can't be somebody's understanding.
Block of statements which is used to perform a particular task.
Okay, block of statements which is used to perform a particular task. Okay, Aparna also says the same. Block of code executed only when called per functions, group of statement to perform a specific task. Great. Right. So now functions is not something, you know, something which is coming from some other planet. Okay. It is very much belonging to the same lines which you wrote previously. But now let's say there is a task of maybe, adding numbers, let's say. Okay. Adding numbers is there. Okay. Every now and then, if you have to add numbers, okay, will you always say C equal to A plus B? Like if you have to write adding of two numbers 100 times, will you go write the code C equal to A plus B, C equal to A plus B, C equal to A plus B 100 times? Will you do that? I am giving you a very small example of adding two numbers, but just think about a complex situation. Right, where you have to perform, let's say you have to divide the string into list Okay, after getting the list, change one value in that particular list, combine it into a string again, and send it back. Every time these lines, if you have to write, do you think it is easy writing it 100 times, 1,000 times? Will your code look good, or will your code be space efficient? Definitely not, right? It will require lot and lot of memory to store the code, and also to while running every time these variables, you know, at times usefully getting created, at times not required also, right? So that's the reason we go and we write something called as functions. What we do is, if there is any task which has to be done 100 times, then what you do, you go, you write a function, you put all the lines of code which has to be done 100 times in that particular function, and call it whenever required. Okay, so it's more or less like let's say, just because you are cooking at your house, you don't get the entire grocery store. If 10 kgs, dal is there in the grocery store, you don't get 10 kgs and put it in your house, right? What you do, whatever you require, whenever you require, you get little and you use it, how much ever you want. Like that, functions, this is not a good example. I think I gave a very bad example, but still, okay. Try to understand, few lines of code which you want. Okay, so those lines, you put it in a function and you call the function whenever you require in whatever place you require, and it performs the exact task. You are not writing the same set of lines 100 times. Okay, if you're writing the same set of lines 100 times, you will use 100 different variables, so unnecessarily you are using up the memory, right? So instead of that, you are using whatever you require in that function, and you're writing. So as everybody said, it is group of statements, okay, which get executed when it is called. Okay, so just, it's very simple. You go and attend a function only when you are called to come to that function, right? Just because some wedding is happening, you don't bump into the wedding and attend it, right? See, if somebody has called you, yeah, there is some so-and-so marriage is happening or a birthday party is happening, you come to my place to attend this function, only then you go. In the similar way, functions also get executed only when it is called. It doesn't go and get executed whenever it wants, okay? Understood? So, I think most of you here in the session know what are functions, but like trying to make people who don't know also a little comfortable with the topics function. So, that's what it does. Now, how do we create a function in Python? It is very simple. You use the keyword DEF. Okay? So, it is the short form of define. Okay? You use the keyword DEF space, you give the function name, okay, you write the function name, you give the brackets, in this brackets you can pass the values whatever you want, how many ever you want, okay, this is how you write it, okay? Now, what happens? What does this mean? This is a keyword which says, yeah, here a function is written, okay? This is the name of the function with which you are going to call it, okay? Then these are the parameters. So, to execute this particular function, what are all required, you will pass it. Now, inside this, whatever you have to write, it should go into a block. So if you have to start a block, you have to end it with a colon. So you ended it with a colon. And now if you go inside the function, you can put all the lines, whatever you want. Okay. Now I'm taking two numbers. So what I will do is, I will say C equal to, or rather, okay, I will say C equal to A plus B. And then I'll say return C. My function is going to add the two numbers which are given and return the result. Got it, everybody? This is a simple function. I told you, right, while discussing the control statements that there is one more, along with break, continue, pass, everything, there is one more return. So return is used to send a particular value to the, from the, let's see, okay, let's discuss. Now, this is a small function, okay? Otherwise, for the time being, I will write it as print C, okay? This is my function for suppose. So this function is taking two parameters, A, comma B. Inside the function, it is adding these two parameters. Whatever value it is coming is getting stored in a variable C, and I'm printing C. This is the function's activity to do. Now, let me just execute this cell. When I execute this cell, no operation or no memory is allocated. Did you understand? Did you all get it, what I mean? When I execute this, nothing will happen. It will just remember, it will just put this code in its brain saying, okay, whenever I see in future this particular function name, I have to come and execute these lines. This is what it will remember. That's it. It is not going to perform any action at this place. Okay. This means, now for suppose it's your birthday. Okay. You know your birthday is on so-and-so date. You have arranged a party there. Okay. You have arranged a small party. You have ordered cake. And you have prepared all the things required for your birthday. Okay. Now, if this particular birthday function has to happen happily, what should you do? You should call your friends. Yes or no? You should call all your friends. Yes or no? So this is like arranging your birthday party. Then whatever action you do later to execute this, that means to make sure your birthday party is happening. For that, you need to call this particular function. How do you call a function? You call your function with the function name. Our function name is function name itself. Okay. And then here you have parameters, right? How many parameters did I pass? I passed two parameters. So I need to pass two values to those parameters. That means for A and B, I need to give two values. So I'll say 10, 20. So what will happen? 10 will go and sit in A, 20 will go and sit in B, right? Now, this is how I call a function. Okay, this is how I call a function. Now, when I execute this, what will happen? The value, whenever I call this function, it will go here. It will say A is 10, B is 20. Go inside. C equal to A plus B, 10 plus 20, C is 30, and it will print the values 30. Anybody has any questions still here? Definitely not, right? It is very, very, very simple, right? Good. Now, I don't want my answer to be printed. I just want my answer to be sent to me. Okay? I called you. Okay, I don't want action to be done at your end. I want to do action at my end. I want to get the value itself. That's it. I don't want to get answer 30 here. I want to store this value somewhere. Then what I do is, rather than printing inside the function, I will return the answer whatever is sent. Okay, done. Return gifts you will give, right? If somebody is coming to your birthday party, there are two options. One option is they come, they see, they eat there itself and go off. That's it. The second option is what? When they come to your birthday, the second way of doing birthday parties is they come, they celebrate, they give you a gift, they eat, they take a return gift from you and then they go. So the second type of function is using the return values. The first one is without any returning. So here only entire operation is happening. That's it. Nothing is coming from the function. Now, if you have to also get something from the function, I will give a meaningful name, okay? I made it as add. And rather than printing C here, I will say return. And then I will say C. Return C. Got it? Now when I execute this, nothing will happen in this place. Now here I'll write. Now this is returning some value, right? When you are sending me something, I should take it, right? Like you are just throwing it. And whoever takes it will take. If nobody is taking, it's just left. It's not like that, right? If you give it to your friend should also catch it or hold it, whatever gift you are sending. In the similar manner, you are returning something from your function. So whatever you are returning, that should be stored somewhere or it should be held by somebody, right? So that holding reference we have to first create. Okay, so let's say D equal to, and then now I will call the function with the values 20 comma 30 maybe. Okay, now when I execute this, the answer of this is getting stored in D. Let's see, let's print D and see. Did you get it? So 20 and 30 is passed to the function. When I pass this 20 and 30 to the function, C equal to 20 plus 30. 20 plus 30 answer is 50, and 50 is returned. And this returned value 50 is getting stored in the variable D. Okay? Everybody clear? Anybody is having any questions? All of you, ECE, EEE, any other branch, whoever is there. Great. Awesome. Now, I am saying I am passing two values here. I am passing two values here also, right? Here there are two values, here there are two values. These are also called as parameters, these are also called as parameters. Can somebody tell me what are A comma B and what are 20 comma 30?
A comma B are formal parameters, 20 comma 30 are actual parameters. A comma B are actual parameters and 20 comma 30 are formal parameters.
You gave two answers there. What should I take, ma'am?
No, ma'am. A comma B are, it is declared, ma'am. That is actual parameter. And the passing values are formal.
Okay. Anybody else, any other answer? 20, 30 actual, A, B formal. Actual A comma B. Oh my God, so many answers. Okay, there is some question also. I'm sorry, I didn't see. Where is it? Ma'am, if we don't assign answer to D, then also we'll get the output now. See. This is what you mean. This is what you mean. Right? What is the use of this? Doing this? What's the use of this? See, this is interactive programming. So, okay, let me say this. Let me do this again. Where is the output? What you were saying? Where is the output? Bindu, did you see what happened? Now, let me say. There is another name, other function also, right? With function name. So if I do this, did you see what is happening? Are you understanding, Bindu? What did you understand from this? Yes, Akhila is right. You can print add of 20 comma 30. Then you will get the result. I was just trying to show what I mean is, print is again holding it. See, there is somebody who is holding the value, right? When you write print, it means somebody is taking the value which you are returning. But if you just write this statement, just like this, there is nobody who is holding the value which is coming from the function. Okay? That's the reason you don't get the output at all. In interactive programming, if you just write this statement in a cell and execute, why this statement? If I just say D also, D somewhere was declared here, right? If I simply say D also, I get the value whatever is there in D as output. I did not write print. Okay? But in batch execution, this will not happen. When I write D, will it get executed? In batch programming, you people tell me? Definitely not, right? Then you should ask me also, ask me, D is containing 50, so D should get printed in your case. It's not like that, okay? If something is returning something, you should give it some holding place. Let it be print. Let it be, list dot append, or let it be tuple dot, tuple you can't add. Or in dictionary, you are trying to assign that value. Anything, it need not be a variable. You are trying to do some operation, then that's fine. If you just write this statement, there is no meaning for it because it is returning the value. That returning value, where are you storing it? How are you using it? You either print it there or you store it in a variable or do something. Only then you will give a holding place to it. Got it? Got it, everybody? Anybody, any questions? Okay. So what was I talking about actually? That also I forgot now. Actual and formal parameters. So there are few who say A comma B are formal parameters. Okay, this is the function. And there are few who say 20 comma 30 are actual parameters. Formal parameters. You tell me, what is the value actually which you are trying to send to the function? A comma B or 20 comma 30? On which the operation is actually getting performed? On which values the operation is being performed? 20 comma 30. That's the reason these become your actual parameters. It's so simple. No confusion at all. Okay? These are the values, 20 comma 30 are the values on which the action is going to get performed in this call. So these become your actual parameters or the actual arguments. And then in the function, whatever values are there, these are the formal ones. Your actual name is Lalita Gayatri. My actual name is Lalita Gayatri. Formally, I am known as maybe Miss Lalita or something, whatever. Okay, so I'm given a separate name by my company maybe. Okay, I'm known as Lalita. My actual name is Lalita Gayatri. Okay, so this is the actual value. But for the sake of that party, I am being renamed to this variable A. Got it, everybody? So this becomes a formal way of calling this value. These are known as formal parameters. Will you get confused any other time in future now? Did you understand why these are actual, why these are formal? To this party, you are called with these names. That's the reason these are formal parameters. These are the values which will be used only in this particular function or in this particular party. But actually, your name or actual value are these. That's the reason these are called as actual parameters. Everybody in the session is clear? All of you? No confusion at all, right? What is the difference between actual and the formal? Okay, great. So, yeah, kudos to all of you that you all understood. Any questions till now? Till now, whatever we learned, do you have any questions? Okay. Now let's see. In Python, everything is an object. I was talking about objects, classes, and all such things in the beginning of the session, right? I will tell you why I was talking about all those things, okay? In Python, even a function is treated as an object, okay? Now, ma'am, what are you even talking? Why a function can be, why should a function be treated as an object? Because in Python, functions act as there are four possibilities for a function. The first one is like this one here. You have assigned a function to a variable, right? So a function can be assigned to a variable. Okay, the second one, you can have one function inside the other function. You can define one function inside other function, right? How and all we will see, step by step. Don't worry about it, I will show you all. But remember, okay, you can assign a function to a variable like we did it before. I already showed you that. You can have one function inside another function. Next, what we can do is we can pass one function as a parameter to other function. Okay, we can pass a function as a parameter . What does this mean? Here, instead of a comma b, 20 comma 30, I can pass some function also here. Got it? Got this? Did you understand what I meant with that? Okay. The fourth possibility is you can return one function as a return value of another function, okay? Like there is a function, you are writing a return statement for that. Return statement of that one function can be another, you can return a function itself as a return for this particular function. I will show you that. I understood you people can't be very clear. Return of one function can be another function also. Okay. It's, you all know what is recursion. Okay, I don't want to anyhow confuse you, but
a function calls itself.
Yes. So it's not about one. If everybody has to understand this. So, okay, fine. Let's go and see one by one. This first one you already know, right? A function can be assigned to a variable. This we just saw. Here we assigned it to a D. A function call is assigned to a variable, right? So you have assigned it to a variable. Now, whenever you call this, whatever value is coming from this function is getting stored in D. The first one we already saw. Now, let's go and see the second one. Okay, let's see how we can write one function inside another function. Okay, so now I will define a function for displaying, maybe. Okay, a very simple function. And I will take a string to display here. Okay, I will write it as S. I don't want to mix with. Okay, now inside this, I am writing a another function, def. And I am writing some message here. Okay. Now, inside this, I am returning some value. Okay. I will say hi. Okay. I will simply say hi. Okay. Then I have returned hi from this function, and now out of this, coming out of this inner function, what I'm doing is I'm just saying, I'm storing some value here. I am calling this particular function, and to this I am adding my name. Okay, fine. This is understandable, right? No, it is not very, otherwise I will take whatever s, I will take s as whatever string you are sending, that and this message I am going to display. Fine. Now I will return this particular string, whatever is generated. Done. This function is clear, I hope. No questions, right? Anybody has any questions on this function? No. Okay. Now what I will do, I will call this particular function. I will, because it is having return, I'm printing it directly. I'm not using any variable. You can use a variable also. But as you already now understood how to store it in a variable, I'm directly printing. I'm saying display and I'm passing my name. Okay, Lalita. Now let's execute this. What happened? Display Lalita. So Lalita is going here and getting stored in this formal parameter S. Now inside this particular display function, there is another function which says message, and here it is returning hi. So this will not get executed until it is called. So what is happening here? I am calling message. Message is returning hi. So hi comes here. And to that, whatever string this formal parameter is containing, that value is getting concatenated and that is being returned from the outer function. And that is printed. Is this clear? Is this all clear or any questions? Everybody. Yes, repeat again. Okay, Akhila wants me to repeat. See, let's go from the end. Okay, first what I'm doing, I'm calling display function. To this display function, I am passing a string called Lalita. Okay, now Lalita is my actual parameter, right? Whenever display is called, it goes here. It assigns S, that is my formal parameter, with my actual parameter. So S is containing Lalita now. It enters inside the function. It sees another function is being defined here. It will just remember there is a function with name message. It will not even see what is happening inside message. It will just remember, okay, there is a function with name message. That's it. Now it will come to this line. It will see message is being called. So now it will go and see, I have a function with name message. So I have to go inside it and see what is happening inside. It will come here. It will see there is nothing, just that there is a return statement. It will return this particular hi. Now here hi is there. And whatever S is containing Lalita. So hi and Lalita is getting concatenated. That is hi and Lalita getting added. So hi Lalita will come and that is returned. That is what is your output. Got it? Now is it clear, Akhila? Or you want me to tell it again? Instead of that, we can directly give it. What giving? You mean hi Lalita, you can directly give? In R. Yes, you can. What you want to give in R directly? Hi. Yes, you can give. I just wanted to show you with parameter. That's the reason I gave it with parameter. Now, if you give Lalita here directly, next time if I have to say hi, Nithi, will this function work? It will always say hi, Lalita. That's the reason I am passing it using a parameter. It's up to you anyhow how you write based on your requirement. I am showing you this simple example just to show that inside one function, you can have another function. That's it. That's my motto at the end. Okay. I'm not saying you have to write only this way. Instead of all this function, you can simply return hi Lalita in that case. Okay. I'm just trying to show you that, what all can be done. Okay. Function, you should never make it static, Akhila, remember. Okay, if I give Lalita here, it becomes completely static. Okay, it is not doing any new task. So that's the reason I sent it a parameter and I'm trying to do it using a parameter. Okay?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Sorry for interrupting, ma'am. I didn't get why did we add pluses, ma'am. Sorry. I didn't understand that statement.
Plus, yes. Okay. Yeah, I can. So now see here, I will print S. What will have in S? What will we have in S?
Lalita.
Okay. What we have, when we call message, okay, let me say I removed this. Okay. Now what will we have in R? Print R. What will we have in R? What do we have in
message,
R? Hi. Hi is there. But if I have to say hi Lalita, how do I do it?
Okay, I got it. Understood.
I have to concatenate both the statements. So yes, instead of writing in a new statement, instead of saying this, R equal to R plus S. If I do this, did you understand this statement now? R is containing hi.
Message.
And S is S is containing Lalita. So R plus S will do what? It will say hi Lalita. So instead of writing so many statements, what did I do? This plus
R equal to message plus this.
This plus this, I wrote it here. And I
function call will return hi and S will return Lalita. Yes. Please.
Yes. So those two will get concatenated. Okay.
Thank you.
Any more questions? Yeah, thank you very much. Any more questions? Any others? Any more questions? No. Okay. Fine. So this is the second thing which I showed you. What is the second one? First one was a function can be assigned to a variable. I showed you how you can assign to a variable. Then the next one is one function inside another function. I showed you how you can write one function inside other function. Next one is passing a function as a parameter to another function, right? There is 1 second. Yes. So now the next one is passing a function as a parameter to another function. How do I pass a function as a parameter? Let's see that. Okay. Now let me define one function. First, let me define a function. Let us take this example only. Same example. I don't want to do something new. Okay, same example. But instead of writing this function inside, I am writing it outside. This can be done, right? I can have two functions. Yes or no? Can I have two functions? Come on, guys.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, I can have two functions. So what I will do here is, I will say R equal to, I will say R equal to S plus Lalita. Okay, fine. This is how my function is. very simple function. What am I doing? I'm having two functions. The first function has one parameter s. I will tell you where s is coming from, what is s going to have. Our main motto is what? This s should be a function, right? Yes or no? I have to pass a parameter as a function. Now s is a function, let's say. So whatever value is coming from that function plus Lalita, I'm concatenating Lalita to it and I'm returning. Okay, I have another function which is returning only hi. Okay, now let's go and let's call this particular function display. I will directly print, I'm not storing it anywhere. Okay, I am calling display function, but instead of passing some value to s, I am passing my message, this particular function as a parameter. Got it? Now let's execute.
Hi Lalita.
Yes, let's execute. What happened? Hi Lalita got printed. So first, what is happening? First display is getting called. For getting display to be called, it requires one parameter. So it goes and sees the parameter. Parameter is a function call again. So it goes and calls this function. What is happening here in this function? Something is getting returned, right? So that return value is here. Now hi is getting stored here. Okay, so the string hi comes here. So now display of hi. This hi goes here as s. And hi is in s. To this hi, Lalita is getting concatenated and it is being returned. That returned value, I am just printing. Is it clear, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Any question? Or anybody who feels all this, we already know. Or it is new to you. How are you feeling? Is it new to you or... It is well like new. Okay. Okay. Awesome. Bhagya Lakshmi wants me to explain. So I'll explain again. I will go again. Okay. Bhagya Lakshmi, see, I have two functions. The first function takes one parameter. The second function takes zero parameters. Fine. This is clear, I think. Yes, Bhagya? Now, what am I trying to do? I want to pass a function as a parameter and show you people, right? So let me start from this print statement. It says there is a print statement inside this. I am calling a function called display. This particular display function, if you see, wants one parameter, right? Now, when it wants one parameter, it goes into the parameter list and sees this statement. This statement is what? Is it a direct value? Or is it a variable? Or what is message? MSG, I mean. What is MSG? It is another function, right? So now, this is a function call. This is how you call message function, right? If you have to call message function, how do you call? You write message and you give brackets, right? Now, when I, this statement, when it sees, it calls this message function. When this message function is called, it sees, it goes inside and it sees there is a return statement. What is message statement returning? It is returning hi, right? So after the return statement, it comes back here and instead of message here, this is how it stores. Okay. For you and me, it is looking as message and parenthesis bracket. But for compiler, now after this message got executed, this is how it looks. Now when hi is sent here, what, how this function get executed, you know it. Yes or no? Yes or no? Display. Yes, Bhagya Lakshmi, are you there? Did you understand now? Or still you have any doubt? Yes, ma'am, for that means you understood. Okay. I am assuming that Bhagya Lakshmi got understood the things. If you did not understand, please come back to me and let me know. Yeah. Thank you very much. Now we have learned how to assign a function to a variable. We have learned how to write a function inside another function. We understood how we can pass a function as a parameter. Now the last one which we have to understand is how do we return a function from another function. Okay, this statement might sound very different, but it is very, very, very easy. Okay, now let me use the same old example which we used before. Let me not create a new one. Okay, let me use the same example. Are this is a function which we are going to use. Okay, now what I'm doing, instead of doing all this drama, I will say hi Lalita here itself. Okay, I don't want even this, because for this example all this is not required. And in the return statement, what I will do is I will simply say MSG. I will simply say MSG. Okay. Oh, is this fine? Did you understand? What did I write? I've created one function display. Inside that particular function display, I have a function named message which is returning hi Lalita. And I am the first function, the outer function's return statement is MSG. That's it, nothing else. Okay. Now what I will do, I will say print. Okay, fine. Let's say print. Now, you people tell me, how should I write the code? Do you have any idea of how should I call display, or how should, if I call display, what will be the output? Any idea? We will get only message. Okay, let's see. Let's write and see then. Display. And I'm calling display now. What happened? What did we get? What is this? What is the output we expected? Is this the output which we expected? We were expecting to get hi Lalita. Yes or no? I don't know how, if you were, but I was expecting to get hi Lalita. But what did we get? We are getting this is all the function ID. Okay. So this is a location of the function. Okay. The memory location. This says, what is coming out? Display.locals message. So that means a message. See, whatever is the return value is a some local value of display. That's what we are getting. That's it. Okay. So it says there is a function with message which is getting returned. Okay. So now how do I get the output? This is not how I get the output. Now what should I do? I should create a variable. I will create a variable. Now in this variable, I will not name the variables big, I'm making them small. I will say variable n, and then now I will call the display function. Okay. Now I'll call the display function and I will say print and n. Got it? This is how I will print. Now let's see. Did I get the right output? This is what we were expecting, right? Yes or no? See, it's very simple. For a message, if I have to call this particular MSG, how do I call this particular function? You people tell me. You people tell me, how do I call MSG? How do I call MSG? Using MSG brackets, right? Did I write brackets here? Did you see me writing brackets here? Did I write? So what is it? What is MSG containing now? When I write only MSG, it will give me the location value, right? So if I have to execute whatever is there inside, what should I do? I got the location. That location, if I have to execute, I will give the parenthesis brackets. Yes or no? I mean, like, I'm talking in a very, very non-programmatical terms. I should not say that location I have to execute only if I put parenthesis brackets, it will get executed like that. I shouldn't use the terms like that, but just to make you understand. Did you get it? So now I have the location value of this particular function. It knows that that is a function, MSG is a function. To call it, I'm doing this. Now, you might say, ma'am, I would have simply done this. Right? Now let's execute this and see. Is this working? Is this working or not? Yes. So Akhila is asking me, why not print message itself, ma'am? Why are you showing us all this headaches? Yes, I will come to that. I am trying to show you all the possible ways of returning a function. Okay. So there are few requirements where you don't need to, get the value somewhere and execute it somewhere else. Okay. Whatever it is, however it is. Okay. So if you have to return the direct value of, if you want to call the function MSG, here I'm not returning the function. Here I'm returning the function call. Okay. Here what happens if this is the code? Guys, try to listen to me little carefully. Ramya, I will tell you what is happening in that statement. Just be with me for a few minutes. I will explain you everything again. Okay. See, girls, what is happening in this statement? When I say return MSG brackets, here I am not returning the function. Remember, here this line doesn't mean I'm returning function. As soon as it sees return MSG function, it will go call this MSG function. Okay. And it will store this return value here and it will return hi Lalita. That means it is returning a string, not a function. Understanding? It is returning a string, not a function. That's the reason in N, hi Lalita is getting stored directly and you are printing N. Okay. Or you can simply write, without all this, you can simply write print display in this case. Okay, if you write print display, directly hi Lalita will come as the output. Did you see? Because brackets are here, function call is happening already before returning. Before returning the value, function call is happening. Whatever that function is returning, that function value is fetched. And it, okay, let me do one thing. Rather than returning here, I will write print statement. Okay, I will say, okay, this is one way. Let me write another way also down so that I can show you the differences. Okay, here instead of return, I will say print. Now you will understand the difference clearly. Okay, print. Fine. Now I will say print display. Fine. Okay, fine. This is enough. Wait, Aisha, just hold on for a moment. Let me show whatever I want to show. Okay. Now this, let's see this statement, this one. Okay, let's try to understand what is happening here. Okay, now I will also say print hi, just hi. Okay, now let me execute this. What is happening? First hi is getting returned, sorry, first hi is getting printed, then it is getting coming here, return message is see, message it is seeing. Okay, return message. So it will go into this message, it will print this hi Lalita, and it will then come out, I mean, then it will return. Okay, after this printing this, it will return. Okay, and then because there is no return for this, whatever has to, now let me show you without these brackets. Okay, now I will say n equal to this. Okay, you see when I'm returning msg, okay, hi got displayed from this function, nothing else got displayed. Now if I give the brackets, what is happening? Hi and hi Lalita both got printed. Are you seeing the difference? Did you get it? When I call the function, after my original function got displayed, also the print statement is getting displayed because it is being called here. Okay, with this particular function, this function is also called in the return statement. Now if I remove this, this function is not yet called, it is just returned and stored in n. Now if I print n, it will have the function values. Okay, it will give me the location, at which location, what is the, which function is being stored. Okay, so display dot message is stored in this particular location. Did you get it? Now if I have to call my function message, I will have to externally do it. Did you get it? Did you understand the difference now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Returning a function is different. Returning the return value of a function is different. So we are trying to return the function and then we are using this function call later on. Okay. Now I can assign it to another variable b equal to, and then I can use it. Okay. Now in b, I will be having my hi Lalita. Okay. Got it? Fine. So, ma'am, if we are printing message, we are getting only hi. What did you write in message first of all? Like I wrote hi Lalita, I am getting hi Lalita. Next, ma'am, why getting like print message again? Like yes, dear, you will get. I don't know what you are getting. Okay, so this is your code. When you are calling display, what will happen? Hi, Aisha. Hi, Aisha.
Yeah, ma'am. So when I'm calling message, we are getting only hi.
Okay.
Like, I didn't understand, like, why we are getting only hi.
This hi is not a part of... not a part of your function. Okay. This is an inner function. Like, why capital hi, that too? Okay, I'll get back to this. No worries. Okay? I will get back to this. I don't know. Even I am confused why you are getting hi. The same thing you are also getting, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I will check on this and I'll come back to you.
I'm getting like small h and I. Hi, like small h.
Uh-huh. So it is returning some random value. Because, see, according to me, it is inside this particular function. Okay?
Yeah.
So this particular function can be accessed only by this function. By display only, through display only, you have to access MSG. You can't access outside. Okay, that I am going to deal with later. like locals and global variables I want to deal, that I will deal in a little later once you understand this topic, I thought. So actually MSG cannot be accessed outside. So what I assume is it is returning some random value. If I just say MSG and C is, see, this is not a function. You saw this? MSG is at some location. But if you see this, if I just call MSG here, okay? And now if I'm trying to display, you see what is happening, which location it is. The location of MSG which is inside the display, and this MSG is completely different. So it is calling some random value. Understanding?
Yes,
so it is calling some random function which is outside in its memory, and it is giving me the output. Some garbage values, okay? So this is actually not possible. Girls, all of you remember, function inside function, if you are writing, this function is accessible only within this particular outer function. You can't access outside like this. If you are accessing, this is what happens. It gives you some random function which is in its memory. And if nothing is there, it will say that particular function is not defined. Okay, let me explain you this also very clearly. What did I tell you? When you execute this particular function, okay, if I have only this, let's say. Sorry. Okay. Let's say if you have only this, okay? And now if I execute this particular statement, okay? What did I tell you? Compiler will remember that there is a function named this display in its brain. That's it. It will not even see what is all there inside, okay? It will remember, okay, in my memory, there is a function called display. Let me see what is inside only when it is called. That's it. Until unless I don't know what is inside that, okay? So, when you call display or when you call message actually, it doesn't know that this message function exists here inside display. Yes or no? Do you get my point, what I mean? When it knows only the name of the function, how will it know that there is another function inside it? Right? So, it doesn't know that message is already existing inside inside the function display. Okay? After display is called, then it will go, it will see, okay, message is there, it will store in its memory, it will see this return statement, it will return, then it will see return message, it will return something, and it will forget that this message is already existing inside this function again. Okay, after this return statement, again it will forget that this function was existing. Got it? Is it clear now? So if you try to access an inner function outside, you can't do it, okay? It gives you some 1 second, guys. Just give me a minute. Now, because MSG was somewhere present in its brain, okay, so now let me change this function name to MS, okay, something like this, and now let's try to access this. Because ideally it should give error, that is how I understand Python, okay. So now if I'm trying to call message, did you see? This is not defined. Because when this function was display was called, it never knew this function is also existing. Okay. Got it? Always see when you are getting some values, some random values from the functions, always try to see it which address it is, and then you will understand things clearly. So here, when I display this, you see already that they are at two different locations. This is not what we were trying to see, right? Everybody is clear with this? Anybody, any questions? With this or with the previous one? Anything? Don't worry, I will leave you now in a while. So If you just say you all understood this, I know it was a lot of things into your brain today. But let me know, yeah, if you have any questions, okay? If I don't know at this moment, yeah, I will go check out about it. Check out in the sense I will not do anything much. I will like see these addresses and like that only. I am also going to debug it, okay? So I will tell you. Otherwise, yeah, most of the questions we are trying to... Ma'am, why we getting like when we print display? Why are we getting this, you mean? See, what are we returning here? MSG. Okay, so MSG, this is not a function call. It will return. It is a function. It is a function. See, MSG will do what? Okay, let me remove this line. This is not required anyhow. Now, when I call display, what is happening? It will go here. It will see there is a function inside. It will see return Aisha. It will come here to this return statement and it will see MSG only. I am not trying to call MSG here. Yes or no? I am not trying to call MSG. Do you accept with me, Ramya? Am I trying to call MSG there? No. When I'm not calling MSG, what will MSG, what is MSG to the compiler or to the interpreter, I mean? To the interpreter, MSG is a function. Because it knows this is a function already, because display is called, we are inside display. And it is a function which is inside display, which is a local object to display, and its name is MSG. And it is present at the location, this address. This is the information MSG contains, okay? This is a reference, I told you, right? Functions act as objects in case of Python. So MSG is an object, and this object is called with these brackets. Okay, when you give the brackets, it makes a function call. Okay, so until unless that is not done, it will give you the information about that particular function. Okay, this is all the information about the function. Now to execute MSG, how do you do it? I told you, right? You will store it in a variable, some variable array. You will store it in some variable, okay? And now you will say n brackets, okay? You'll have to write it in the print, okay? And execute. Now it gives you hi, Aisha, okay? Here you are making the function call with a different name, okay? So actual name of the function is this, but this is a formal name, okay? Using the formal name, you are making a function call. Got it? Is it clear, Ramya, now? Girls, I didn't get what MSG and MSG. Fine. No, I will tell you. Okay, let's say I am trying to give you a call, okay? I have information stored on your name, okay? I say, I have stored your name, Ramya. I have stored your contact number and your details, whatever I know, okay? Contact number, I have saved in my phone, okay? You tell me, if I click on your name, what will I get? Will I be able to talk to you just by clicking on your name in my phone? Or do I have to also call on the hit on the call button? Don't tell me, ma'am, Android I use, I have to do a swipe, please. I'm talking about the basic phones, okay? You have to hit on the call button, right? So when I click on your name, what do I see, you tell me? It will open your contact information and it will show me what is your number. I mean, like what all information I have stored about you. Yeah, phone number it will show me, right? Similarly, in case of function, if I have to view the function, the phone number of the function, if I have to see, functions don't have a phone number to call. I make a call, but without the phone numbers. Okay. Fine. So the phone number of the function, if I have to see, just see, okay, I write MSG only. And to make a call, I will say MSG brackets. Now, is it clear? This is the phone number of the function. N contains, or MSG, only MSG contains the phone number of the function. MSG brackets will contain, will make a call to the function, will make a call to you. I will make a call to you when I hit on the call button. Like that, MSG is called using MSG brackets. I hope it is clear, Ramya. If not, please let me know. I will try to trace out another better example, maybe. Not only Ramya, anybody in the session, please tell me. No, in the sense, it is not clear, you mean. Okay, fine. Fine, no problem. Let me say print. Everybody else is clear? Anybody else who is having any doubts? Anybody else? All of you, please, except Ramya, everybody else, please respond. Did you all understand? Anybody is having any other questions, please let me know. Ramya, don't worry, I will explain you. Maybe you're thinking it is a little complicated, but it's not that complicated, okay? If you understood the example, you should understand the difference also. I will make it clear, okay? Everybody else, right? Okay. Awesome. So guys, I would say if you are clear with this, you can leave the session because I'm done for today. I'm not going to teach any other new concept. We will meet next week again. Thank you very much, all of you. But if you have any questions, please stay back. Okay. And then I can explain you whatever questions you have till date. Okay. Guys, this is the best chance for you to interact with me in person and get your doubts clarified. Not only with me, Nidhi is also here. I think she can also unmute and she can also talk. So if you have any questions, if maybe I am not explaining in a better way, maybe she can also try and explain you. Okay. So anybody who is having any questions, who want to ask us in person, yeah, this is the right chance. So all the others can leave the session. Only people who are having questions can stay back and ask us questions. Fine. Bharan.